was one important attribute, the fact that everybody in the team scored goals. I mean, it wasn't just left to Mick Jones and Alan Clark. Everybody got them, didn't they?
That's right. Alan Clark got plenty of goals because that was his great asset. And Mick Jones was a tremendous player for our team. But Peter Lorimer got them, Eddie Gray got them, Billy got them, John got them, even fullbacks got them, Pappini, Terry Cooper, because they'd come on the overlaps. But they could all control the ball, John, one touch. And they could all play and they had a great vision of the game and great quick brains on them. And all I wanted to do at that time was learn every day. In every training session, every match, I wanted to learn something new. And we kept adding it to the team. But there were type of players you could just talk to and they knew what to do.
If I'd changed the goalkeeper, I think if I'd changed the goalkeeper, David Harvey, quicker for Gary Sprake, I think possibly we'd have won the championship and more cups, because Gary did make a few boo-boos at vital times in semi-finals and league matches when he got towards the end of a season, where we lost it on goal difference, lost it by 1 point. And I think if I'd done that, we'd have won more trophies. Billy Bremner on the right, who was electric. He was quick, over 10 yards. He could see things out the back of his head. He could cut ball between people. He could lift games out of nothing. He could play 1-2s and set things off, and then your team tackling him back if he made a mistake or anybody else made a mistake. And he was one of the world's greatest players. And then on the left, of course, you had John Giles, one of the most gifted players I've ever seen in my life. Two-footed, could pull it out the air, get it down, pass it. Defenders would come to him, John, and if a defender was coming on his left side, he'd just take up his left foot out the air and turn on his right-hand side to give him space away from the fellow that was coming to tackle him. If they came on the other side, he'd take up his right foot onto his left foot. And so accurate with his passing and see things. And another one that was always involved, Billy Bremner and John Giles were always involved for 90 minutes in everything. You start off with David Harvey, who came as a schoolboy, 15-year-old, and waited many, many years to get the chance and played a fantastic part in his winning the FA Cup final with his great save with a deflection from Frank McClintock early doors. Well, Paul Rainey was a fitness fanatic. When he marked best and people like this, never used to give them a kick out. But defensively, Big Jack was a tower of strength. And in attacking situations, getting under the bar and getting goal from us with corner kicks and things like that. Norman Hunter, he got the same performance as the Norman Hunter for 42 matches a season. He never used to drop his performance. It was always a level of about 85% every week. And then you had Terry Cooper, one of the most gifted left backs who could go up to people and beat them. Not quick, but go up and just shake his body and get them off balance and just ease past them. And then in that lot, you had, of course, Paul Madeley, the Rolls Royce, who played in 10 different positions for me. The only position he didn't play was goalkeeper. Then you had Billy Bremner on the right, who was electric. He was quick, over 10 yards. He could see things out the back of his head. He could cut balls between people. And he was one of the world's greatest players. And then on the left, of course, you had John Giles, one of the most gifted players I've ever seen in my life. Two-footed, could pull it out the air, get it down, pass it. Up front, we had Peter Lorimer. They had a shot in football, you know, when people could really hit them, like Bobby Charlton, Franny Lee, he won a prize of £500, a silver salver, for 78 points, something miles an hour. But Mick Jones was unselfish player. He could knock it up to Mick and he could hold it till he got support from the middle of the field or players round about him. And he was always in there challenging, good in the air, got a lot of great goals for us, and that was my privilege to manage him. And then you got Clarkey, Sniffer. One of the best players I've seen going to a goalkeeper and going round him and sticking it in the back of the net. Eddie Gray, I think he'd have been better than George Best. And I'm not just saying that. I think if that lad hadn't had a pull muscle, he would have been one of the most exciting players that the world's ever seen.
Those players meant that even when physically paralysed, Don Revie could live on his Leeds memories.
Clark! What a goal! What a goal! Magnificent! Run of success. Leeds United are turning on a brilliant show, and the other team are just not on the bark.
Fittingly, the Don's last season with the club was crowned with the league championship. Leeds' second league title, though, the prelude to a bombshell for the club. In July 1974, Don Revie tipped to be the next manager of England. And the pundits got it right.
Delighted to have been made England team manager, and one that's it's a sad day to leave a club that you've been with for 13 years.
Under Revie, Leeds enjoyed the most sustained period of success in their history. Two league championships, the FA Cup, the Football League Cup and two European Fairs Cups.